be going through some ups and downs and some ins and outs, but you remember, that's my wife.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Amen. That's all right.
And that's the way it is.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Lord.
With Christ and his church.
Yes, Lord. Uh-huh.
And when he comes again,
talk about it, son.
He's going to be looking.
Talk about it.
For his church.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Yeah.
He's going to be looking for his bride.
Yeah.
I just hope that the Lord will be able to find her, because sometimes she try to act like other women.
Yeah.
His wife,
yeah,
is special.
Yes, she is.
His wife is unique.
Yes, she is.
Talk about it tonight.
Talk about it.
Yes, sir.
When you're in the room and your wife is there, when it's time to go, you get your wife.
Yeah. Come on.
Come on.
You don't reason within yourself that it doesn't matter what woman I get, just as long as I leave out of here with one.
Come on, come on, come on.
If you reason like that, you may not get out of here. His wife is unique.
Yes, she is.
One of the reasons, and I say this, I'm not ashamed to say it, one of the reasons why, and I'm not saying this because my wife is here, I've said it before, one of the reasons why I was attracted to my wife was because she was different.
Yeah, yeah, talk about it, come on.
From everybody else.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Yes, sir.
She was different, and that's what caught my attention.
Come on.
Was that she was different than everybody else that was walking around on that campus.
Well,
she was different. And that's why I appreciate her, because she's different. And not only that, but because she's my helpmate.
Yeah.
She don't help me make the bills, but she's my helpmate.
Yeah.
Are you with me? You see, the church, man, is special.
Yes, yes.
To Christ. And that's why he has a relationship.
Yes, yes.
With his church. When Jesus comes again, he ain't looking for all of these other women.
Yeah. Right. Come on,
these
son.
Other women.
Yeah.
Here in Kansas City. Yeah. All these other women that are down there in Wichita. He ain't looking for them.
Come on.
He's looking for his.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's the one he's looking for.
Yeah.
And that's the one he's going to take back with him.
Yeah. Yeah.
Amen. Amen. Now, let's move on for just a few moments. We're just about through. Now, when we look at this, we see that there's a relationship. Well, when we look at the church, let's take a look and see what's in the church.
Uh-huh.
What's in Christ. In Ephesians chapter 1 and verse number 7, the Bible tells us something that's, well, let's go back to Ephesians 1 and verse 3. And let's take a look at that real quick. As we hasten on to our conclusion, I got to hurry up because I want you to come back tomorrow night. Now, in Ephesians chapter 1 and verse number 3, the Bible says what?
Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Blessed be the God and the Father of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Read.
Who has blessed us.
Now watch this. Watch this. Notice now. He has blessed us.
Yeah.
You hear that?
Yeah. Yeah.
What are you talking about? Notice he didn't say he has blessed them,
right,
or he has blessed everyone.
Uh-huh.
He says he has blessed us.
Yeah.
Let's read.
With all spiritual blessings. In heavenly places
wherein Christ. Hold on.
Yes,
this helps us to understand something. There's a difference. Now stay with me now. There's a difference between us and them.
Yeah, say that again. Talk some.
Listen.
Come on, say it again.
There's a difference.
Come on.
Between us. Well, who's the us? The us are those who are in Christ.
Yeah.
Those who are in Christ are who? Those who are in the church of Christ.
Yeah. Yeah.
There's a difference between us
and them.
And them.
Come on, son.
Because he has blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ. All spiritual blessings are in Christ. And those of us who are in Christ can access those spiritual blessings.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Let me tell you something.
Yes.
Everybody can't access spiritual blessings.
Come on, sir. Say it again.
Because spiritual blessings are for spiritual people.
That's right.
Amen. 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 Oh, yeah, yeah, man. Yeah, 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 yeah. See, folk on the outside of Christ don't have access to the spiritual blessings that are only in Christ Jesus. Well, how do I get those spiritual blessings? Well, what are one of those spiritual blessings? Well, go down to Ephesians chapter 1 and verse 3 and read it down to verse 7. You come across several spiritual blessings. But one of the spiritual blessings that you come across is in verse number 7, where it says what?
In whom we have redemption.
We have redemption. We have redemption through his blood. What?
The forgiveness.
The forgiveness of our sins.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Now, who is it in here who don't need forgiveness?
Yes. Yes.
Yes. Who is it who don't need forgiveness? We all.
Come on,
yes, Lord.
Even on your best day as a Christian.
Come on, sir. Come, sir.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Need forgiveness.
Yes.
Because we sin by omission and by commission. We sin by not doing the things we should do.
That's right. That's right.
And we sin by doing things that we should not do.
That's right.
Is that all right?
Yeah.
But where do I get this forgiveness? The forgiveness is in Christ Jesus. And if I'm outside of Christ Jesus, I can't access forgiveness.
That's right. That's all right. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Man, all of us up in here
yeah.
need forgiveness.
Yeah. Amen.
You may sing loud and you may give big, but you need forgiveness. Everybody in here needs forgiveness. From the pulpit to the vacuum, everybody stands in need of forgiveness. And the only way to access forgiveness is to be where forgiveness is.
Where is it at?
That's in Christ.
Talk, sir. That's Amen. It. That's it.
Every spiritual blessing, reconciliation, grace, salvation is in Christ. 2 Timothy chapter 2 and verse number 10. The Bible says there, I endure all things for the elect's sake, that they may obtain the salvation which is in Christ with eternal glory. Is that all right? Salvation is in Christ. Salvation means to be rescued from danger.
That's right.
Well, how do you ever expect to get rescued if you're not in Christ. You have to be in Christ because that is where salvation is. And when you're in Christ, guess what the Lord does? He puts you in the church of Christ.
Amen. That's right.
In Noah's day, there was only one place of salvation.
Yes.
Where did you hear me?
Say it again.
In Noah's day, God told Noah, listen, well, I'm getting ready to destroy the world because the world has become continuously wicked. I want you.
Come on, son.
What?
To build an ark.
Yes, sir.
And I'm going to give you the specifications.
Come on, son.
Of this ark.
Come on.
I want to build out of gopher wood.
Yeah.
You hear what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe Noah had to take some notes because for me, I'll take some notes and make sure I got it right. The ark was the only place of salvation in the entire world. Somebody says, well, that was just a territorial flood. No, man. That flood covered the whole entire world. And the only place in the world where you could be saved was in that ark with all of those animals. I can see us now. Man, I ain't getting in there with all them stinking animals and stuff. But that was the place of salvation. Every animal.
Yes, yes.
Two by two. Male and female. It wasn't no two males.
Ha 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 ha